some black mechanic gloves. So that way, later on when they go inside, track in any dirt or grime or anything greasy. Won't make the wife happy if they do that. Oh, here we have an Inline 6 engine that came out of our 1928 Chrysler sedan. I believe it's a 72 series. I'm not quite sure yet. Been looking for markers. Kind of let me know what kind of series this is. So until I find out, I'm going with 72. What do you guys think? Here as well, we're going to jack up our inline 6 engine as soon as I can get the cover off of the flywheel here. So I'm not sure what we need to do for that. I'll bring you over so you guys can kind of take a look here. This flywheel goes up into this plate here, and it doesn't want to come off. So from what I gather and I've seen, is that I'll have to take this off. Believe it or not, somebody put this in at one point. This was like a carriage bracket, and they welded it together, but we're going to take that off because it's just not needed. So I'm not sure exactly what they used it for, but we're gonna take it off anyway and see what happens, and we'll go from there. Chilly today. Not too bad. Not too bad for April. Goal for today is get the engine on the engine stand. We'll see if I can do that or not. This is an old carriage bolt or carriage bar that someone welded on. I think it was to hold in place the starter that goes right in here, but I can't say exactly why they did that. Hello? Any ideas? The other piece of that bracket that was on there, that was being held by a 13 millimeter bolt, while the other two were being held on by a 15 millimeter bolt. I'm not sure why people do the things they do. Alright. Kind of gross. Behind the flywheel, 17 millimeters. Nuts. use that dowel pin and a wrench for getting these bolts from behind here to keep the flywheel from spinning on you. Use some penetrating, it doesn't come out on you, either use heat or use some penetrating oil, let that sit, come back and try it again the next day. We're going to move on to the back of these other nuts, that way we can just keep on moving. Alright, now you take our handy dandy wrench. Do the same thing again. Keep on wrenching. Flywheel bolts. Saw a guy use he was making boxes from a 3D printer. And he was labeling each one. And I thought that was pretty cool. I have to do something like that myself. I don't lose anything. Just use your fingers. Whew. I gotta get some knee pads on here soon. Please. round is. Each one that would come out. Keeping in the thing, or is that keeping something else? Well, that about does it for the engine so far. I'm gonna have to figure out some way to get that flywheel off. I've been told online that I just could smack it with the hammer, might need to use some type of puller, and then someone else said I might have to just take the entire bottom off where the oil pan is and take out the column from the inside. That way it leaves some wiggle room to get the flywheel off, and then I can finally mount it on our engine stand. So stay tuned for next time. Thanks for watching. Be sure to subscribe and don't forget to follow. See you guys next time on Schroeder's Garage.